Hello?
Yes, may I speak with Brenda?
This is her.
Hi, Brenda. This is Fenris King. You sent a deliverance request form on the 6th of the month?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you still interested?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. First of all, how did you find out about us, Brenda?
I was on YouTube. I was on YouTube and I seen your the videos you had.
Now, what was you up there looking for a particular subject matter?
Not really.
Mm-hmm.
But I was looking at this one particular that you had by Spirit Spouses.
Okay. So just share with me what you wrote. I wanted to get deliverance over my life. My situation is unexplainable. So just share with me what's going on in your life that is causing your separation from God.
Well, my parents are from, they're both from Haiti, so I just feel like there's just some things that's actually going on with the whole family that's affecting me too, but I feel like it's affecting me more because it's like nothing, I can't get nothing right.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just weird, because I feel like I'm just having a challenge in all areas of my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I just can't end up the right and done, and I just feel like something is behind it. And
So you were born here in America, but your parents were born in Haiti?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, did your parents ever share with you their experiences in Haiti?
No, not really.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, some things are shared, but not everything they'll tell you.
Right, okay. Now, Brenda, have you given your life to Jesus Christ?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Are you attending a local church in your area where you get together with other brothers and sisters in the Lord and fellowshipping with the Lord?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, good, good. It's just that it's like everything you set your hands to do, it's just not working out.
Right.
Now, are you faithful to God? Are you staying obedient to the Lord in the area of understanding that He has revealed to you? Are you obeying Him?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, are you married?
No, single.
Okay, you keeping yourself pure before the Lord in that area?
Yes.
Huh?
What did you say? I'm sorry.
I couldn't understand you.
I couldn't hear what you said.
I said, are you keeping yourself pure before the Lord in that area of your singleness?
Yes, ma'am.
Good, good. Now you do have a natural affection for men. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, you don't have an unnatural affection to be with a female?
No.
Okay, good, good. All right. So tell me about your dream. What type of dreams are you having? Have you been experiencing?
Ooh, a lot of crazy dreams. Dreams that I somehow understand now. Like dreams, sex in the dream. Dogs chasing me. People trying to feed me stuff in the dream, snake dreams, half human, half horse, half human, half fish, like a mermaid spirit.
Okay.
Stuff like that.
Okay. And your parents never talked about their life practices while they're in Haiti.
Okay. My mom has, because I know they have their thing in Haiti, their religion, their ritual thing that they do.
Right. It's voodoo.
They serve their idol, whatever that is.
Right. 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 So your parents, now your parents serving the Lord now?
My mom is. My dad, he's not well right now, so.
Okay.
I know he was going to prison before he got sick or whatever, but I know
I have another young lady that I ministered deliverance to on last year. She lives in Florida, originally from Haiti. What part of Florida are you in, Brenda?
Right now I'm in Davenport. Near Orlando.
Orlando, okay. I think she's a little further up. Now, did you ever have a chance to go on our YouTube channel and listen to the deliverance of Farrah? Farrah is from Haiti.
Yes, I've seen that video.
Yeah, Farrah is from Haiti. Yeah. And the things that is happening to you seem happening to Farrah. And that is because, somewhere down the line, because your ancestor worshiping voodoo with the satanic practices, that family lineage was dedicated to Satan. So that's the reason why you keep having those attacks like that, because those marine demons, you're still linked to them. Okay, but the Lord's going to set you free, Brenda, but it's very important that you stay free. Now you're going to have a battle fight, but remember, it's the Lord who fights your battle, okay?
Yes.
You just worship and praise him, okay? Now, tell me about, what type of church are you attending? What type of church is it? I mean, do they teach strictly the word of God? So when you go, you actually feel yourself being fed the word where it's causing you to think of your Lord Jesus Christ and want to continue to have that relationship with him.
Yes.
Now, do that church believe in deliverance?
Yes, ma'am.
The casting out of devils?
Yes.
Okay. Have you shared this problem with your leadership in your church?
I actually was going to this one other church, but it's been kind of different from the church that I'm now visiting. Because the one that I'm visiting now is a deliverance ministry.
Mm-hmm.
I met this lady named Miss Lorna. She helped me, like she'll pray on me and deliver me and stuff.
So,
but I think I'm just now starting to go there. So as far as she done moved to New York, but I'm still going there. But the pastor, I feel like God do things on his timing or whatever. Mm-hmm. Because I'm sure they see it. If it's on me, they see it on me, you know.
No.
I just feel like,
mm-hmm.
I don't know, I'm just to a point in my life where I just want all of it to stop.
Right.
I want whatever is in me, out of me, completely, right now. I just want it. That's how bad I want it.
Amen. Okay. All right. So, again, let's go back to your church. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, it really saddens me that people going to their local church And they are not being set free because the Holy Spirit is not the one who's in control there. Because if truly mm-hmm. the Holy Spirit was the one in control there, you'd be free by now. I'll be quite honest with you. So my concern is, what are they teaching? You know, Who is the strong man of that house? Is it the Lord Jesus Christ, or is it those marine spirits? Now, let me ask you, the majority of people there, are they from Haiti?
No, it's actually an American church.
It's an American church.
It's a Black American church.
Mm.
But I just started visiting there.
You had just started visiting this church. You haven't been going there, you know. So actually,
I didn't make it my home church, but I've been going there every Tuesday.
Okay. Now, what was your home church? Your home church.
The one I was going to, it's a community church. It's like Black, white, and this and that. But they don't do it. You know how
they don't believe in deliverance there, period. At your home.
I don't know if they don't believe in it. I just haven't seen that there.
That's because they don't think it's necessary. They don't think it's necessary. They probably one of them just don't believe that a Christian can have a demon. So they don't think it's necessary. They're one of those churches that believe once you give your life to the Lord, everything is taken care of. Everything. Spirit, soul, and body. But that's not, it's not true. Okay, so that's your home church. So the church you're going to now, you really don't know much about it, but you but they do believe in deliverance, believe in at least acting out of doing deliverance. But they're really not where they should be in that area. Okay. All right. So God's gonna set you free, Brenda. It's just that you now at the church you're going to now, when you sit in their midst, you are being taught the word of God and you are learning of Jesus Christ. Not of that ministry, not of that leadership. But of Jesus Christ, you are experiencing that, so that's fine. Okay, that's fine. All right, praise the Lord, and that's what you continue to do because you need to continue to grow in the things of God. Because I sense you as a babe in Christ Jesus. You're a babe in Christ Jesus. It doesn't matter, you know, how long you've been saved, but in the spirit, I sense you to be a babe in Christ Jesus. So you need to be nourished and fed the word of God so you can grow. You put in mind this other young girl that I talked to on yesterday, the same thing with her, a babe in the Lord, and you need to grow, and it's the word of God that you need to hear so your faith can be strengthened and developed in Christ Jesus as you grow. Also remember, Brenda, the Lord will set you free, and you are free. You will be free from devils from the working on the inside of you. You will be free that the thieves are no longer inside the house. Your house, your body is God's house, okay? So the thieves who are devil will no longer be in that house, in the house, but they will be on the outside. You know, when thieves are on the outside, they work to try to do whatever it takes to try to get it back into a house. Is that correct? When we're talking about physical thieves, where spiritual thieves who are the devil, Satan, and his demons, they are thieves. The Lord said they are thieves, and their aim is kill, steal, and destroy. So when the Lord casts the thieves out of us, they're on the outside. And that's where they're supposed to be. They're on the outside. But they does everything in their power to try to convince you to let them back inside the house, to open the door. They only can come back in if you open the door. And how you open the door for them is through disobedience. Okay? So you have to obey the word of God, James 4:7, by submitting to God. Then when the thieves come back, you'll be able to resist the devil and the thieves will run from you. So, now I'm going to tell you this. Some of the ways that I have found that they try to operate and deceive a person, let them back into the house, is that the same way you knew that they was in you by the things they did, by seeing them in the dreams and stuff. Well, when they are out of the house, in order to convince you that they are still in there so you can open the door, let them back in, you're going to have a dream of them again. But this time, you say, oh, no, devil, in Jesus' name, you and I in me, Jesus set me free. I received my deliverance from Jesus Christ by faith. He have cleaned his vessel. He have cleaned his house. So in the name of Jesus, get away from me in Jesus' name. That's what you say right there in the dream. You have power in a dream to say that because you are spirit. Your spirit never sleeps, okay?
Yes.
And also you do it physically as well. Because remember, they're going to try to persuade you to let them back in, okay?
Yes.
Now, are you married?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Do you desire to be married?
No. That's the one area I have problems in, so relationship and finances. Right. Everything is crazy. I don't know.
Right. Everything is crazy. But do you, within, desire to be married one day?
I know. I want that. It's not like I don't want that. It's just not happening for me. Nobody's interested in me.
No, I ain't talking about that part. I'm talking about your desire. Is it something on the inside of you that you desire to be married one day? Don't think about it. It's not working out now. Is that desire there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That's natural. That's good. Nothing wrong with it. And I'm glad to hear that because that's a natural desire. You know, nowadays, Satan have given men and women unnatural desire to be married, to be not married, and also to marry the opposite sex. So that's a healthy desire. There's nothing wrong with that desire. What's wrong is that we go out ahead of God trying to, you know, find someone who we think is best, and that's what we messes up. But you just keep, just do like you're doing. You just keep your affection on the Lord and trust Him that at His time, He will connect you to the one that He have chosen, okay? Now, be very careful in that area because since it is a desire and the enemy knows it's your desire, even after you get set free, the enemy will try to hook you up with the wrong person, okay? So you be careful about that. Even someone come to you after your deliverance, someone comes to you, express an interest, that should make you think, why all of a sudden I'm being someone is interested in me now. Be careful because that may be the enemy who sent that person as an agent.
I'm being very careful about that right now.
Oh yeah, that's right. Be very continue. Be very careful.
People out there, and I just see too much going on with people in their relationships. I'm going to wait on God. I don't want to rush. I'm going to take my time.
Amen.
I
want to
finish school. I want to get close with God first.
So how old are you?
32.
Okay, so you're 2 years older than the girl I spoke with yesterday. Okay. All right. Yeah, you're right. You're very young. Just continue to wait on the Lord and trust the Lord. And then at God's time, you know, because whoever He hook you up with, they going to be deliverer just like God deliver you, you see. Right. I thank God for you. You seem to have a very sweet spirit, sweet young girl. And just continue to keep your priority in the right position. God come first in your life. And another word of wisdom, Brenda, is whatever you do, want to do in life, I don't care how minor it is or how minute or small it is, you consult the Lord. You see if it's the will of God for you to do it. Just don't up and decide to do a thing. You seek the will of God. You know, you have a heavenly Father. You got a heavenly Father, a Father who cares for you. He's watched your every move. And whenever you need an understanding about something or you have a decision that you need to make, then you talk to Him just like you talk to your mom. You talk to Him because He's more real than your mom. He will never leave you. Mom will leave you one day, but He will never leave you, you see. So you say, my Heavenly Father, I thank you. I come to you in the name of Jesus. I only come to you in the name of Jesus. I have a concern, and you're my Heavenly Father. I know you care for me, and this is my concern. Reveal to me, show me what you want me to do. And then the Lord will either answer you in a dream, or you'll be in a conversation with a stranger, and all of a sudden, just a normal conversation, he say something, or she say something, you'll be like, that's what I asked the Lord. That's the Lord who just told you your answer. You see, that's how he works. Yeah. That's why you don't hold no out against nobody, because you don't know who God will use to talk to you through. You know?
Yes, ma'am.
He used an animal to talk to his servant. He cares about you. Regardless of how your parent, your father, your mother, or relative, or who treat you, remember, you always have a friend in Christ Jesus. He'll stick closer to you than any parent, than any sibling, any family member. He's always there. You can always call on him. When devil come trying to harm you and put fear in you, you just say, Jesus. Yeah, that's all you just call on his name, Jesus. Because you're calling him from the heart, and he answered. And then he send those angels. He was like, oh, that's my child. He'll send those angels, and the angels just will take them devils and do whatever they do to them. Because that's how much he cares for you. And you always remember that. And as you remember that, that pumps you with hope. You always will have hope. Now, the moment you take your eyes off Jesus, you have no more hope. You feel lost. And that's how the enemy wants you to feel. And that's what the enemy wants you to do, is take your eyes up and mind off of Jesus so that you can feel hopelessness and loss, so that he can send those spirits to you to kill, to steal, and to destroy you. But as long as you keep your focus on Jesus, the devil, he can't grab, he cannot get a hold of you, because you are hidden in Christ Jesus, okay?
Yeah.
And it's good that you're learning that in such a young age. Very good, because a lot of traps that the enemy has set for you, because you have this knowledge and understanding, you're now able to step over and bypass those traps. Okay? So you're really blessed, whether you realize it or not. When you become a whole lady in life, you're going to remember what this woman told you, and you're going to really, really... You think you see now, but you're really going to see, and you're going to say, thank you, Jesus. That lady was right. Oh, and then you're going to look on the young people. You're going to tell them the same thing. That's how it goes. Praise the Lord. I wish I had someone to tell me this, but a lot of times you hear a person say that. If God would have had someone there to tell them that, they wouldn't even listen to them. Because some kids have to find out the hard way. But I thank God there was a lot of things that I did listen to. And so there was a lot of traps of the enemy that I didn't fall into, because I listened to my elders. Godly elders. Because there are plenty of elders out there, but they're not godly. They are ungodly. You don't want to listen to them. You respect them, but you don't obey them, because they are ungodly. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to say a prayer for you, Brenda, and then I'm going to speak a disconnection, and God can set you totally free from the thieves on the inside. And then you praise him and thank him for the goodness that he have done for you. He have done a goodness for you, Brenda, that you can't even see. And you praise him and thank him for. See, Jesus actually does way more for us than we actually see, than we actually feel. That's why we have to receive from him by faith and believe by faith that he done it, because he actually do way more than what we ask. You know, some people, unless they have a lot of money, unless all their plans are being fulfilled right before their eye, that's the only way that they can really proclaim to other people and get excited that the Lord has given them abundantly and above all that they could think or imagine. And it was only because they could see it or because they can feel it. But that don't please God, Brenda. Faith is what pleases God. Faith pleases God when we believe that he have given us abundantly more than what we ask or think. And we ain't seen a thing, but he done it. That's what pleases him. He smiles. And that's the best. Receive it from God by faith, okay? And that's what you do. You receive from God by faith, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen. So, Father, in Jesus' name, once again, I thank you for my sister and your daughter, Brenda. You have sent another daughter to me to encourage her in your son, Christ Jesus. Father, I just thank you for these opportunities you've given me in sending these young girls and men to me to point them to your loving son, Jesus. And I pray and I ask and I believe and I receive and I thank you for keeping them safe from all evil, protecting your precious treasure in them, building and raising them up to be the great man, in this case, woman of God, that you have chosen her to become, Father, giving her more insight and wisdom into your word and revelation of your son, Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you that no weapon that was formed against Brenda and all her property, it shall not prosper. I thank you, Father, for putting a shield of protection around her and all her properties, Father, by the fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for strengthening her will, strengthening her mind, Father, to serve you. Continue to give her a hunger and a thirst after your righteousness through your son, Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for keeping her safe from all evil. Her and all her family, her children and her children's children, Father, in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father, for your mightiness. I thank you, Father, right now, in Jesus' name, for hearing of and for hearing your word and seeking to perform your word hastily. I praise you and thank you. I thank you for this mighty deliverance that's taking place in the spirit realm, Father, in which you are delivering your daughter from the bondage of the evil one. And I thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. I praise your holy name. Father, you said whatever I bind and loose on this earth, you will bind and loose in the heaven. And I thank you, Father, for being with us through your son, Jesus Christ. Give you all the praise and glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So Brenda, you just listen in the conversation, okay?
Okay.
So in the name of Jesus, I command you, marine demon, you've been marine spirit, you spirit husband, pack your load. Every spirit, you are not of the Holy Spirit, I command you to loose her now. Come out. Come out of Brenda's mind. Come out of her will. Come out of her emotions. And come out of her body now. Come out. Spiritual poison, come out of her body in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire burn. Burn from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Sweep out every spirit that is not of you. Give Brenda a clean flushing, a clean sweeping by your mighty fire. Fire the Holy Ghost. Burn in the name of Jesus. I take spiritual scissors in the spirit realm and I cut and sever that spiritual umbilical cord to detach Brenda from you, spirit foul. You marine demon, in Jesus' name, I take the blood of Jesus. I pour over that covenant that is known or unknown. And the blood of Jesus breaks and destroys that covenant and contract. The blood of Jesus, nullifies that contract and covenant in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost, continue to burn, Holy Spirit. Burn everything out of her that's not of you. Come out. Out of her mind. You have no more legal claim and right to her. She don't belong to you. Jesus destroyed that covenant and contract from 100 generations ago by his mighty blood. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. It's the blood of Jesus who sets her free. The blood of Jesus redeems her. The blood of Jesus crucified her. The blood of Jesus bought and purchased her. The blood of Jesus sets her free. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Out. 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 Out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. out in Jesus' name. Father, send forth your angels right now in the spirit realm. Gather every spirit that's not of you. You send them where you desire to send them, Father. Father, you said in Jesus' name, whatever I bind and loose on earth, you will bind and loose in heaven. Right now on this earth, I bind every spirit that is not of you, Father, in the name of Jesus, and I cast them at you, Father, to do with them whatever you desire to do with them in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, out. Come out, out, out. You are never to torment her again, physically, spiritually, nor in the dream. Out in Jesus' name. Pack your load. Out, out, out in Jesus' name. Out. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, continue. Burn, burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit. Holy Ghost fire all over her body. All over her body, from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Holy Ghost fire, burn. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. Burn in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Out. Out. Jesus commands you out in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, out, 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 out. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, continue to burn. Give Brenda a clean flushing, Holy Spirit, clean flushing, Holy Spirit, by your mighty fire, by your mighty fire. Only you can do this, Holy Spirit, by your mighty fire. Let Brenda feel the comfort of your love and compassion from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Leave no compartment untouched by your mighty fire, by your mighty fire. Every name that is named on this earth, under the earth, in the sea, in the ocean, in the air, in the name of Jesus, you must bow to the name of Jesus. Out in Jesus' name. Out. 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 Out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Out. Out, 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 out in Jesus' name, out in Jesus' name, out in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, Holy Ghost fire, continue to burn. Burn, make Brenda's body, her spirit, her soul so hot. The enemy cannot stay in, must come out completely in Jesus' name, 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 in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, be free. Be free, Brenda, in your mind. Be free in your will. Be free in your emotion. Be free in your body. For the blood of Jesus, for the blood of Jesus have set you free. Be free in Jesus' name. Be free in Jesus' name. Be free in Jesus' name. Be free. Jesus' name, be free in Jesus' name, be free in the name of Jesus, be free in the mighty name of Jesus, be free in the mighty name of Jesus, be free in the mighty name of Jesus, be free in Jesus' name, be free, be free, be free, be free in Jesus' name, be free. Be free in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for a clean flushing by your mighty fire. Fire the Holy Ghost. Burn. Burn in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Go. Go. Out, 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 out in Jesus' name, out in Jesus' name, out for the blood of Jesus, nullify and destroy that covenant contract. The blood of Jesus. She's in a new household of the family of God. She off limits to you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, we praise you and magnify you. We thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for the completing your work today in Brenda's soul, in her mind, in her will, in her emotions, Father. Father, I thank you, Father, for setting of your blazer, hot fire around her, Father. Father, we praise you and magnify you, Father. Father, I ask you, Father, is there anything in her home that separates your presence from her, Father? I ask you, Father, to reveal it to her, Father, so she can get rid of it, Father, in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father, for the angels that are around her right now. I thank you, Father, for completing, setting your daughter totally free, for Jesus died for our freedom. Jesus died for our healing, for our salvation, for our deliverance. Thank you, Father, for touching your daughter, your daughter, your daughter of Abraham, Father. Thank you, Father, for setting Brenda's mind totally free from the enemy, from the thief, her will, her emotions, and her body, in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, be free, Brenda. Be free. Be free. Be free. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Out. 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 In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. 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 Brenda? Brenda. Who are you? Who? Brenda? Brenda. Brenda. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you in Jesus' name? Speak. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Spirit of dying, go. Go in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, that out. Get out. 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 Holy Ghost fire burn. Holy Ghost fire burn. Holy Ghost fire burn. Burn all over Brenda's body. From the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Burn, Holy Spirit. Burn, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Out. In the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Continue to burn, 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 burn. Burn in Jesus' name. Out. 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 Out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. Out in Jesus' name. Out. Peculo, all of you, out. In the mighty name of Jesus. Out. Out. Out in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Continue to burn. Continue to burn. Holy Spirit, give Brenda a clean flush and a clean feet. Fire the Holy Ghost. Fire the Holy Ghost washes her from the crown of her head to the soles of her feet. Fire the Holy Ghost burn. 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 Fire, 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 fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Out in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Brenda. 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 Say, I renounce.
I renounce.
every covenant.
Every covenant.
That my parents.
That my parents.
And my grandparents.
And my grandparents.
And my foreparents.
And my foreparents.
Formed. With Satan.
With Satan.
By faith in Jesus' name.
By faith in Jesus' name.
I renounce it.
I renounce it.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Say, Brenda, say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For setting my mind totally free.
For setting my mind totally free.
My will totally free.
My will totally free.
My emotions totally free.
My emotions totally free.
And my body totally free.
And my body totally free.
To serve you, Lord.
To serve you, Lord.
Amen. Now, Brenda, what I want you to do, I want you to think, is the Holy Spirit bringing anything to your remembrance that you have done and you have not confessed to doing it? You haven't confessed it to anybody. Huh?
No.
Were you ever sexually molested?
I don't know.
You don't know. Now, what I mean by that, not only, you know, have someone ever physically slept with you, but was there anybody ever, as a young girl coming up, ever touch you inappropriately with a sexual intent? Or have you ever, with your eyes, seen sexual contents when you was a little girl?
I think so.
You say you don't think so?
I think so.
Share that with me. Share that experience with me.
What you want me to do?
I want you to talk about it. Tell me about it. What happened? See, confession sets us free. When we hold back and don't confess, then that caused the enemy to keep clinging and holding on to us. Because the Lord told us that if we confess our wrongdoings and forsake them, he will have mercy upon us. So you have to confess. God chooses the godly vessel in whom you can trust to confess things to. You don't confess to everybody, but to the one who God have chosen. But there's something you need to confess so that this demon spirit of death and dying can let you go. You hear me, Brenda?
Yes, ma'am. I don't remember anything being molested, nothing of that, never. But I think I have a feeling it happened. Mm-hmm. I don't know about who.
But you feel like it happened, but you don't know by who.
Right.
And you seem to can't remember any details about it.
No.
Okay. Do you have used to have occasions where you fear you had a dread or feel the dread of dying?
Sometimes.
Yeah, that's that demon spirit. So. Have you ever had sex with a guy?
Have I ever had sex before? Yes.
Yeah. And about what age?
Started when I was 18, I think.
18 was the very first time you ever had sex.
Yeah, with my first boyfriend.
Okay, and when you met him, you were a virgin.
Yes.
Okay. And that boyfriend you had was not a Christian, was not saved. He previously had sexual relations before as well.
Right.
Okay. So anytime before your 18th birthday, you never had a problem with lust, you know, desiring to be with a guy.
No.
Or watching sexual content, pornography, or masturbate.
Yeah, I used to look at that stuff.
Pornography. That was before you lost your virginity. So you was in pro pornography. Okay. And now, can you remember the around the age that you first started pornography?
I think I had to be maybe 14 or 15.
14 or 15.
Well, it could be 13, too.
Okay. Okay. So, let's say at 13, before 13, you never had a sexual feeling before the age of 13.
I have.
So before the age of 13, you had a sexual feeling.
Yes.
Okay, now tell me.
I remember one day when it happened in my room.
Okay, you was in the room. Could you remember the age?
I had to be about around 14, I think.
Okay.
About 14 or 15.
Okay, share with me the details of that incident when you first had that sexual feeling.
I had that feeling, and I don't recall doing anything to earn that feeling, but I just had it for a couple of minutes and it just went away. I just forgot about it.
So at that particular time, can you recall what were you thinking and what were you doing that could cause you to have that sexual feeling? Or do you think that what caused that sexual feeling was a few years back is when you was molested? And again, molested don't just mean that you was penetrated. It means that someone touched you inappropriately with a sexual intent, and that spirit can transfer.
Probably.
Okay. But you just can't seem to remember the details of it.
No, ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, in either case, that's when those marine demons enter. And okay. Now share with me your conversion when you came to the Lord. I want you to share that experience with me. How did that happen?
Okay, it was in 2007. Mm-hmm. I had my first daughter. I was going through a lot. My child's father wasn't helping me. He wasn't giving me child support or nothing. Everything just went down for me. I lost my job. I lost my car. I just had no finances. I had nothing. I felt alone and abandoned. Even though I had my mom and my sister around me, I just still felt alone and abandoned. I felt like I had no help. And it came to a point one day I wanted to commit suicide. I said, I'm going to kill myself because I didn't want to live like that no more. Because they already didn't. It wasn't right.
Okay. Go ahead.
I just didn't want to live no more.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like nobody loved me and nobody was there for me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And my sister was attending this church. This Pentecostal church. They had a place they rented out and made a church, but it wasn't a building yet. God that was going to her church sent her a message to me for me to come and visit and everything. But, you know, before that actually happened, I started to read my Bible. And then that suicidal thought went away.
Mm-hmm.
I said, let me just try and, you know, see if things get better for me.
Okay.
So that's when I started going to her church, and that's when I gave my life to God.
Yeah, you gave your life to the Lord. And yeah. And who led you into making a public confession that you gave your life to the Lord? Did someone at the church have you to make that a public confession? Public confession, I mean, you know what I mean by public confession? Yeah. Do you understand what a public confession is?
No.
Okay. I'm gonna give you a physical example. That's what I gave this young man. Lord, led me to give him the same physical example, but it's a good analogy. You know, it's when you meet a guy that you really like. I mean, you really like this guy. This guy is in your heart. He's in your mind. He's in your every thought. And he become your boyfriend. You become his girlfriend. What did you do? You make a public confession to let everybody know this is my man. That's a public confession.
Right.
Now you understand what public confession is? So when we come to the Lord, a public confession is very important, because when Jesus is truly deep down in our heart, just like that boyfriend is deep down in your heart and in your mind, embedded in your mind, hey, what's in your heart, your mouth will speak. Well, when you are truly born again, you're going to make a public confession. Look, I am a new creation in Christ Jesus. I am new. The old Brenda is done away with. Behold, the new Brenda. I'm new. I serve the Lord, my God. He's the only God I serve. No more or no longer do I serve my fathers and my father's father gods, but I serve the only God who is the Lord Jesus Christ. That's a public confession.
Oh, okay.
And when you make a public confession, that seals your deliverance. Okay?
Okay.
So after the day, whenever the Holy Spirit, matter of fact, you know, you make the public confession, you know, right? I want to hear it now. And then later on, when the Lord put you in the midst of people, you make that public confession. That's very important. That again, that seals your deliverance. Because when a person don't make a public confession, because for another example, for instance, it's this guy you really don't care much about, but he just keep nagging you, and you say, okay, I'll go with you, but you really don't care nothing about. Well, you're not gonna make a public confession.
Yeah.
You don't care nothing about them. You know what I'm saying? So when we don't make a public confession, we actually telling the Lord we don't care nothing about you, and that's what Satan, and that gives Satan legal right to keep attaching himself to us. So we have to make that public confession. Okay. So I want to hear you tell the devil who it is that you serve. You no longer serve the gods of your forefathers or your parents, your grandparents, your great-grandparents, and from 100 generation on down, however how far it goes, you choose to serve and have chosen to serve the Lord thy God, who is the only God. Now you make that public confession right now so that devil can hear you say that.
Hey,
now you were saying in your own words.
My own words.
Mm-hmm. You just make that.
I bring this from the child of the living God. I serve the living God.
Mm-hmm.
I am a new creature, and the old has went away. I am delivered. I am set free.
Amen. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name. Man, I like that. Now that comes strong from the heart. Mm-hmm. Woo! Yeah, that came from strong, deep from the heart. That's not that. When you first picked up the phone, a little sadness there, a little baby shyness, sadness there when you first picked the phone, that came from the heart. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And when you go to church and you meet people, see, I didn't know that was important, Brenda. When I first gave my, well, I, be honest with you, I just couldn't even tell you when I was born again. All I knew, I was born again. I was, and because I did like you, I saw myself where I need the Lord. I was studying the Word of God. I was meditating upon Him. And that thing I knew, I was born again. I'll be honest with you. And I remember, and I didn't know anything about a public confession. And this is what the Lord did, but the Lord knew the importance of making that public confession. Mm-hmm. I went, my husband and I was attending this church, and really that church wasn't a cultic church, really, because they only talked about their organization and teach on Jesus Christ. But the Lord had us still go there for about a year, and then he took us away from there. And he had us to go there for a reason, because the light of God in us, it shined, and those members saw it, and some of them got changed by that. But anyway, mm-hmm. I remember we were going into services that morning, and there was one of the elders at the door to greet the people. And now I know it's nobody but the Lord had that man to ask us this question. He never said anything to us before. Never spoken. He didn't make an initiative to speak to us. But when we approached the door, this man had the audacity to say, "What's new?"
I never knew that was him either. So you just told me that.
He said he did. He had. Now, check this out, Brenda. He didn't talk to us. He didn't say nothing else. But he just had the audacity. When he saw her, these two words came out of his mouth. "What's new?" Well, when he said that those words went deep down in my spirit. And, mm-hmm. I felt my inner man lift up, and out of my mouth came, "What's new? I'm new." And when I said that, he jumped back. That was a public confession, and I didn't even know it. And that sealed my salvation and my deliverance. Yeah. I said, "Lord, thank you," because I did not have nobody to tell me that. I didn't know it. But see, the Lord knew that was important, and I had to make mm-hmm. that public confession. And that's the way that He did it with me. Because I shot myself, "Why am I acting like this?" But it was my spirit man. My spirit man was born into the family of God, into God's family. My spirit man knew it was new. And I said, "What's new? I'm new." And I didn't say it real low either. That thing came out powerful with a force, and the man jumped back. That demon in that man had to jump back.
Yeah. I'm glad you told me that. I never knew that.
See, that was something. I don't know if you heard that demon of death call itself a dying spirit. Did you hear it? Huh?
Have I ever heard about it?
Did you hear that spirit through you?
Yes.
Could you hear it? Well, I asked it who it was. It said a spirit of dying. So it was a demon spirit of dying, and it was clinging and hanging on. I'm like, "What in the world? This thing should let go and go. What is going on here?" You know? And mm-hmm. then I knew it had some kind of, it said a legal right to be there. And so I just keep talking and just trust the Lord that the Lord would reveal and bring it out, because I didn't know what was causing it not to go, you know? But I trust the Lord.
Dying and death is the same thing, or?
Yeah, it's the same thing. Dying, fear of dying and death. It's all the same thing. It's the spirit of death. Mm-hmm. And so I said, "Well, you know, Lord will reveal." I said, "I'm not going to give up. Lord will reveal why this thing hanging on." You know, I said, "Just let me start talking to Brenda." It didn't want me to start talking to you. That's why I kept calling you by name. And so that's what it is. You got to make that public confession there. You already made it to me. You made it. The devil can hear it. But when you get with them group of people at the church, Hey, hey. Mm-hmm. We need to do that, Brenda. We need to let people know, look, I'm a new creation in Christ Jesus. I'm new. Old things are done away with. The old Brenda's no more. That Brenda that will mope around and pout and because things wasn't going the way that she wanted it to go, I'm not that Brenda no more. My trust is in Christ Jesus. My faith is in him. You see how we got to speak the word of God? Don't speak your circumstances. Yeah. See, that's what invited that spirit of dying into you because you kept looking at your circumstances, which was dying. Everything was dying. And so that's what you kept confessing. You see? You were publicly confessing death by speaking those circumstances that you were seeing that was dying. Get it?
Yeah.
You see? And see, that's what caught that spirit that stayed leached onto you like a leech. It clinged onto you like a leech. You know, it's not only just a leech, but an octopus too, just holding onto you because of that. But you speak words of life. Regardless of how your circumstances are going, you speak life. Refuse to speak what you see. You speak what Jesus is saying, regardless of what your circumstances is speaking to you. You say, no. Brenda is a new creation in Christ Jesus. I speak what's in the Lord. He's life and abundant life. I'm going to speak the word of the Lord regardless of how my circumstances is speaking. Because that's not who I am. That's not who I am. And then as you do that, you literally feel life in you growing stronger and stronger. And then the light of God in you shines brighter and brighter. And then when devils are in other people, they see you, you're going to literally see demons through them with them big eyes looking at you. And then that's when you say, yes, thank you, Lord.
Was that the only spirit that was in me, or?
There was more, but that one kind of was a stronghold. Now, that spirit was there, but that was kind of the stronghold that was lingering in there. I couldn't tell you how many was in me. I felt once when the Lord delivered me, I did feel one lead, but I knew I had plenty. Because the strange thing with me, God is so awesome, Brenda. He does things the way he does things. He be delivering us and we don't even know him. I didn't even know God was delivering me. I remember when he was doing a deliverance process on me, because I didn't have no human vessel at that time to teach me and show me like the Lord is allowing me to share with you. But all I knew is for about a period of a couple of months, every day I would take and spit up the sticks fleeing. I'm like, what is the world wrong with me? I said, well, and I would spit it out. And the next day, the same thing. Finally, after a few months, it stopped. There was those little tiny demons. But the stronghold was still in me, and it took God to get it out through his chosen vessel. And that's when he sent me to the woman of God. And that's when that spirit left. And then that's when I realized, Lord, you set me free and I didn't even know it. So I don't know how many jokers it was. And I don't care to know either, long as they stay where they at. But the main thing, Brenda, we got to maintain it by continuing to be obedient to the Lord. The Lord have set you free in the spirit. You're no longer attached to that covenant of your forefathers. You're no longer attached. People find out you from Haiti. Don't let people look be aware. Church people now, when they find out that that your family's from Haiti, you will get some strange looks. But you know what, Brenda?
Yeah.
You tell the devil in Jesus' name to go back to hell with his looks, okay? Because you are in the family of God. Don't let the devil through those people cause you to belittle yourself in Christ Jesus, okay? Because so-called Christians who don't have understanding of God's word, they're like that. When a person say they from Haiti, the first thing they do, they go misjudging them, condemning them because of satanic worship is the national religion of Haiti. And so they just associate everybody who come from Haiti as serving Satan.
And okay. Most people don't serve it. It's because of what their parents or their grandparents have them commit to that.
Right. And the very ones over here who born in America who are judging, they serving Satan. But they can't see it. So you don't let the devil discourage you on that, because you are now just like you was birthed into your father's family physically. Now you of a new household, a new family. That's the family of God, and the family of God supersedes all family. You see. So you learn your identity in Christ Jesus. Learn who you are in Jesus Christ. You don't have to learn who you are in your natural family heritage, but learn who you are in Jesus Christ. That's what you need to know, so you can mature and grow and develop spiritually in Christ. Become a strong spiritual man in the spirit in Christ Jesus.